This video is a part of a series of videos on staking to lines within Leica Captivate. It will show how to use the Stake to Line app for staking and measuring a grid of points relative to a line segment. Some features of the Stake to Line app are only summarized in this video, but are fully described in the Staking a Line, Line and Segment Methods video. Please do watch that video to learn even more about this app. We will use the example house project, where several different lines form a road, a building footprint, a service line, and a pipeline. Our task for this video is to stake and measure a grid of points based on the orientation of the building, so we will use a segment of the footprint as the reference line. Let's take a look at where our line might come from. As described in other stake-to-line videos, to be used in the stake-to-line app, the line must exist in a normal job. Either the line already exists in the job, for example, it was already measured or imported, or it will need to be created, for example, by importing attached CAD data or by creating a new line using existing points. Accessing the stake-to-line app is simple in the home screen. We choose the job on the job carousel and then tap on the stake to line icon. A list of stake line tasks appears, and from here we can choose the task stake grid. The define line screen is where we choose our line to work with. Any lines that already exist in the job are listed here with details about the line. As described in other stake to line videos, here we can also choose what will define the height to be staked, and we can access the Create app to create new lines based on existing points or entered values. For this task, we already have our line in the job, so we will go to the 3D viewer to choose our line to work with. We tap on the line, and to indicate it has been selected, it becomes highlighted and shows the line direction. This becomes important when we define our grid, and we could reverse it if necessary. We confirm our selection with OK, and are then taken to the Define Segment screen. As our line is a polyline and has multiple segments, we need to choose which segment we want our grid of points to be based on. Here we could choose the segment number of our selected line, and even apply a shift to temporarily move the line segment for the duration of the task. To make selection easier, we will go to the 3D viewer and tap on the correct segment. We confirm our entry with OK, and are then taken to the Define Grid screen. Here we determine how we are going to stake out our grid, relative to the line segment. We define the distance along the line to the first grid point, our starting point. We define our grid spacing across the line and along the line. This will automatically increment after measuring each point. Here we define the behavior of what happens when we move to the next grid line, whether we want to walk in the same direction or in the reverse direction, like in a zigzag mode. And finally, we choose how our point ID will be formed, whether it will use the normal point ID template or be made up of the grid reference. For our task, we want to actually start before the line, so we will enter -5 meters to start staking the grid 5 meters before the beginning of the line segment. We want to stake out every 2.5 meters, so we enter 2.5 across and along the line. For efficiency, we will measure the next grid line in reverse direction, and we will store the point IDs using the grid reference. Before we enter into the stake screen, we will make some changes to the settings which are appropriate for our task. We press Function and then Settings, which we could do from anywhere in the app. We will choose Help Me Navigate using Line being staked. We are only measuring a grid of points, so we will uncheck differences before storing. We have finished with the settings, so we will confirm with OK and then press OK again to continue into the stakeout screen. The stakeout screen is very similar to all stake apps within Leica Captivate. On the left are pages of values and inputs. On the top right is a 3D viewer, which consists of 2D, 3D, Navi, and stake views, and underneath, values of our current position relative to the stake position. The stake screen and staking process is described in more detail in other stake videos. We will begin by staking the first grid position using the stake view. The graphics guide us to the point, and when we are close enough, we can press store to record the point with the grid position as the point ID. The next grid point is automatically incremented, and we can repeat the staking process again. If for any reason a grid point cannot be staked, for example an object is in the way, then we can press skip point to move the stake position along without recording a point. When we have staked all our required points along the first line, we want to move across to the next line. We simply press next line, and then the stake position will jump across to the next line, perpendicular to the last measured point. After staking and measuring each position on this line, the stake position now moves in the reverse direction based on our grid definition. We can continue staking our grid points easily and efficiently until our task is complete. We have seen in this video how to stake a grid of points relative to a line and had an overview of the powerful features and settings available in the Stake2Line app. Other videos will continue with this house project to show staking a line or a segment of a line, and also staking a line with a slope, all using the Stake2Line app. Thanks for watching.